Hello guys, we're back in New York. Woo-hoo-hoo. Beautiful day outside. It's 8:15. I've been up since what I can only describe as the crack of dawn, actually pre-crack of dawn, 4:30. The jet lag has got me. But I'm here and I'm really pleased to be here. I am staying in the East Village this time, which I think is my favourite part so far. I was in NoHo the first time, then I was in the West Village, and now I'm in the East Village. And it's like apartment tapas until I decide where I want to find my own place, hopefully. Yeah, I'm here for a few weeks and the apartment's absolutely beautiful. It's amazing, I'm so happy with it. And just currently sat doing some work as it is Monday morning. And yeah, just feeling so good to be here. What's that notification? I was wondering what, like, with this whole new way of life, which is amazing, but really overwhelming, I didn't know whether you guys might have any specific questions about it and about what this feels like, and I can do my best to articulate and answer any of them, because if I'm honest, I actually most of the time don't know how I feel. Whether that's a good sign or not, I don't know. One thing I do know what to talk about though is some books, because I finished one on the flight. Guys, something very upsetting happened actually. I left my Bose headphones, the new over-the-head ones, in the taxi yesterday coming from the airport, and it was totally my fault. Obviously that is completely my fault, but obviously when something's your fault and you're obsessed about it, you want to blame somebody. So this is my attempt to blame somebody, the taxi driver. We'd like pulled up outside the apartment and he just stopped in the road as they do here. So the guy behind was like beeping on his horn, beep beep beep. So we were rushing out the car, and then I put the headphones in the top of this tote bag. And I looked in and I was like, oh, they're not there. So I was like, hang on, I just need to open the door and check where my headphones are. So I opened it and looked in and couldn't see them because it was like a black leather seat. So I assume they must have just been really hard to see or fallen on the floor maybe. And I opened the door and I was looking and he was like, I gotta go. And went pretty quickly. And I was like, oh, maybe they were in the bottom of my tote bag. Anyway, they weren't. I honestly nearly cried. I was just so frustrated with it. I can't believe that's happened. Anyway, it's happened, we must move on. Very upsetting. Books. Oh, I finished, the last one I read when I was in Lisbon was Junkie by William Burroughs. I've never read any of Burroughs' work before. I loved it. I believe he's a completely despicable man from what I was reading about him online. And the books, kind of like his memoir to his lifelong heroin addiction. I enjoyed it so much. I loved his style of writing. I just found it so interesting as well. So I really want to read The Naked Lunch by him. Is it called The Naked? It is, and Queer. So they're on my list to get, but really recommend. It's like a quite short book as well, which really was brilliant. And then I finished this on the flight, The Year of the Witching by Alexis Henderson. There's a quote from the Daily Mail, which we don't love, but describing it folk horror, which I think would be a fair genre to give it. I never read anything of that genre and can say it's not my cup of tea. This was like a good read and everything, but just really not, like, I don't think that's my kind of a book. I don't think folk horror is the genre for me. If it is for you, then you might enjoy it, but don't really recommend that one that much. I'm still working my way through this, The Walker, which I am really enjoying, but it's actually more about pieces of writing on walking. So it starts with Edgar Allan Poe, and then it goes on to The Old Curiosity Shop by Dickens, and I just read H.G. Wells' The Invisible Man. So we're talking about different themes of walking and how those bits of writing explored walking in a modern city, which I'm enjoying, but I haven't read The Invisible Man by H.G. Wells, so I'm kind of thinking, is this one I have on my shelf and dip into when I've read the books that this is talking about, because I kind of feel like I'm coming in halfway through a TV series, is how it feels. So I'm just going to slowly chip away at that one. And then I'm halfway through The Woman Destroyed by Simone de Beauvoir, which I'm really enjoying. It's short stories. I've done the first two. The last one in this book is The Woman Destroyed. I really, really enjoyed the first two. And I've never read any of her work before and think she's got herself a new fan. She'll be thrilled, won't she? She needed that. So very much enjoying that. And then when I finish that, I'm really excited to read this one, which I already talked about, The Reactor by Nick Blackburn. And also this was one that I bought in Lisbon too, Virginia Woolf The Years. I've only ever read To the Lighthouse by her, and I also read that a really long time ago at uni. You kind of read things differently, don't you, then? As in, you actually have to really think about it. But I remember enjoying it, so I'm excited to read this, but mostly fell in love with how beautiful this cover is. And I believe you can get a few of other of her works in this edition, which is so nice. So that was a book chat. Oh my gosh. Yeah, please, obviously, send your condolences about the headphones. Isn't it annoying when something like that happens? And it's when it's just your fault and you're like, why was I so stupid? Why did I not look more? Why? Ooh, so frustrating. Anyway, no one was hurt, so everything's fine. I'm just gonna sit and I'm actually gonna FaceTime Mum and give her an apartment tour. And then they have some, the owners of this place have some, who I know have some beautiful bookshelves filled with books. So while I'm staying here, I have no excuse to be shopping for books. If anyone sees me in a bookshop, just come and punch me clean in the face and say, get out of here, you've got enough. Yeah, I'm gonna FaceTime Mum. And then I'm just gonna get on with some work and then head out and see some friends later. I'm not sure that anything feels more New York than walking home from a night out in Manhattan with two slices of pizza. Pizza. I need them. I need them. Oh. I had way too many drinks. Way too many beers, but I want to eat this on my way home because it's the kind of food that's going to taste better outside than inside. You know what I mean? New York's in blue. Hello guys, this really good t-shirt that I got, Sea Spot Run, the National Geographic and a cheetah. Got it today at a vintage shop on East 12th. Really sporadic style of vlogging for me at the moment, just trying it out, seeing how we go. Taking a bit of pressure off just while I kind of acclimatise myself once again. My friend Hannah gets here today for a few nights, so we're gonna have a very fun few days. I'm excited. It's sunny, but it's cold. And aside from that, all good. I've got some new vintage Levi's on that I got from General Front in Dumbo. Front General, General Front. It's on my Google list, my New York Google list, which I'll link again in the description box. And yes, that's all I've got to really update you on. I am having a lovely time. My city, my love for this city at the moment is boundless, I'd say. It's so nice to be here. And yeah, I'm hoping that sharing it in this sporadic way might feel a bit more fun. We'll see, won't we? Thank you.
teacher. She's just dying to meet you. She's just dying to meet you. She won't leave till it's done.
I am unwell. Oof. Living at 100 miles an hour is caught up with me. I am full of cold here. Just making a throat coat tea, which when I first discovered that there is tea in America called throat coat, couldn't quite believe. But here we are. It's just a herbal tea. I make myself that and sit at home and work and rest all day in my lovely kitchen, the place I'm staying at. So nice. Here for a few more weeks and then going to somewhere in Soho, hopefully. Which will be lovely. And my grand plan was today to take you guys to the David Wonorowicz exhibition that's on, which I went to a shop yesterday with Hannah, who's left now, called Printed Matter, and bought a book, which I'll show you actually. We can do a big book chat. About David Wonorowicz, who for some reason I keep reading a lot about at the moment. I don't know, I'm having a moment with him. And the guy at the till said, oh, do you know that there's this exhibition on? I completely forgot the name of the gallery, but I will make sure the information is in this vlog, where it's like he had years and years worth of correspondence with somebody else, the man didn't say who. And it's like an exhibition of those letters. So I was gonna do that today, but I don't feel up to it at all, actually. I feel like I just need to stay inside and rest and then hopefully be better tomorrow and do something like that tomorrow. And still take you guys with me then, but today is a day of resting for me. Check out my t-shirt, In and Out Las Vegas. Got it from I think I showed you the leopard t-shirt I had already, the National Geographic one. I got it from the same shop, which was on East 12th Street. Pretty sexy sinus spray and a toilet roll and a tea, throat coat, and a snotty tissue, vile, whole thing's vile. Also, while I'm complaining about my body, I thought I'd give you an update on the IUD, which we in the UK call the coil. In America, you guys call it the IUD. I didn't specify that in my last video. And someone commented being like, really trying to work out what the coil is. It's the form of contraception, the IUD. I've had it in for like a couple of months now. And the two main like symptoms I'm getting from it are apparently a spot on my chin. No, that's a joke. Really bad cramps when I'm due on my period, which hasn't been, I've only had two periods since I had it in, and the second one has come sooner than it normally would, but I think it takes a while for your cycle to regulate before it almost can disappear altogether. Not your cycle, but the bleeding essentially. But yeah, the cramps are pretty bad enough for me to want to take painkillers every day. And also my boobs are so sore. That's kind of the thing that's bothering me the most, because they're so sore to the point that like it keeps waking me up in the night if I roll over in a certain way. Just so tender. Apparently it's all things that would settle down, and obviously I ultimately still think it's worth it all. It's not agony or anything like that, but just thought I'd update you guys. I'm actually probably gonna go and have a bath in a minute just because I've got really bad cramps right now as well, and just sitting in water does help. And I feel absolutely fucking rotten. And then I'm gonna start editing some of this vlog, which I'm really looking forward to doing because I've just been filming here and there, I can't really remember what's in it. That's quite a nice feeling. And I might just like put a face mask in while I'm in the bath and rolling around like this because my tummy hurts so much. And just try and not be in this much discomfort for a minute. Anyway, so it turns out you can still, the load can get you anywhere. Getting my hair done on Thursday, I had to find a hairdresser here because obviously I cannot go to my beloved George Northwood. So a friend recommended one, and I'm getting my hair dyed, which I can't wait for. And that's ending on a positive. Trying to end on a positive. Good morning, guys. It's me. Wearing a really good tank top today from COS that they sent. It's navy blue. It's coming up very black on camera. I just took a photo for Instagram stories, but it's navy blue, and it's very navy blue in real life. A good thickness, slightly see-through, not wearing a bra, but I like the width of this. I'm not a fan of a racer neck a lot of the time. I think with big boobs it can be quite flattering, but this is the perfect raceriness. It's absolutely not warm enough to wear a tank top today, but part of my being ill, I'm very warm. yeah, feeling a bit better today. I've been doing COVID tests, by the way, and it's negative, it's not COVID or anything. So I'm actually gonna venture out today. I'm just waiting for a call, which is in 3 minutes time, and then I will go out and get coffee, and then maybe this afternoon see whether or not I'm feeling up to doing the exhibition, the David Warnerovich exhibition that I mentioned yesterday, which is at POW Gallery, P-P-O-W. I think that section's gonna be very small, so it should be manageable and low energy. My mum just sent a message just saying, ooh, I don't know what's coming next. But yeah, still feeling pretty grotty, but better. And I think I look marginally more alive than I did yesterday. I've started reading, we're gonna do a brief book chat, the new Douglas Stewart wrote Shelley Bain, which I loved. I'm reading Young Mungo. And you may have noticed that this book wasn't initially on the pile of books that I showed you and said I wasn't buying any more new books, but I got waylaid and I bought two new books. No, I bought four new books. I bought this one, which I'm really enjoying. This one by Emily St. John Mandel. I've read Station 11 by her and really liked it. And then two that I got yesterday at Prince of Matter, or the day before yesterday. Ways of the Earth, Tape Journals of David Warnerovich. See what I mean? I was having a moment with him. I don't know what's going on with me. And Walking Through Clear Water in a Pool Painted Black, which is collected stories by Cookie Mueller, lots of which are set in the East Village. So I wanted to give those a go. These are both from the same publisher as well. They're really nice covers. So that was the books that I didn't buy. I wouldn't do that. When I said I wouldn't do that, I'd never go and do that. Got yes another cup of throat coat tea, and I'm gonna do this call and then venture out into the blue skies to go get a coffee. All right, guys, slouchy outfit for the day. Arket jumper, the men's one. I've got like a cardigan underneath as well. Levi's new incredible beautiful shoes. Big splurge from me from the Row. They're like an oxblood loafer. This is my third outing in them. Outing one, I got a bad blister on the end of my toe. Outing two was fine. Kind of a bit sore at the end of the day, but I had walked like, I don't know, 15,000 steps maybe in them, a lot of walking. Outing three, they're feeling really, really good. And then I'm gonna take this bag that I was sent that matches this jumper so well from Wandler? W-A-N-D-L-E-R. Anyway, let me close it up at the top because it's a really nice shape. There we go. How nice is this? Really like the skinny strap and everything. And it just matches the jumper really well. And I'll take my Cutler and Gross sunglasses. But yeah, slouchy because still not feeling 100%. Therefore,
This is a very good I am snotty outfit. And I'm just gonna go and run some errands. Yes. Just got a smoothie, also matches with everything. God, I just can't get it wrong today. Did just sit there and over-listen to somebody explaining NFTs to somebody else, which is my sign that I've had enough outdoors time today. Clean green from Juice Press. Gonna go get my nails done. The exhibition I want to go and see is no longer on. It finished yesterday. Don't want to talk about that. Hello guys. Just gonna end the vlog with talking about these jeans, some new jeans from Weekday. I got Hannah to bring them over for me because they don't ship to America. They're the pin jean. I've got my normal size, which is a waist 26, and they are tight. Like, I've worn these like 3 times, and as soon as I eat or anything, I have to undo them. So I would recommend going a size up potentially, and they're like really tight through the crotch and everything. But because they've been, you know, Hannah bought them out, beggars can't be choosers, and we're making them work. But they are a really nice fit down the bottom of the leg. These are in the washed black shade. Hang on, this mirror might be a bit better. Tiny bit maybe to clean the mirror. But yeah, they're like a washed black and they're a low rise. That's my tummy rumbling. They're a lower rise than the row or anything like that. I love the row, but sometimes they feel very high rise and they have a really nice fit over the tush, which is lovely. But yeah, I would size up. But I just wanted to mention them. So that's gonna be it for this vlog. Hope you enjoyed it. I'm actually gonna get my hair done today, so next time you see me, I shall be blonder, which I'm really looking forward to, and hopefully not sounding at all snotty. I'm still at the end of this cold. But yes, thank you so much for watching. As always, links in the description box, and I will see you in the next one.